Hi guys, in this hands-on lesson, we're going to create a VPC configuration with AWS CloudFormation. Now, I have a template for this, and this is on your screen right at this moment. So you can see quite a bit of information in here. We can see the VPC CIDR being specified, and we've got some default values here. You will have a chance to change these. You can either change them in the template file or in the CloudFormation console. We then have the subnet 1 CIDR blocks, so we have the CIDR blocks within our VPC CIDR for our subnets, subnet 1, subnet 2, those are both public. Then we have private subnets, private subnet 1, private subnet 2. Then you can see some more resources here. So we've got the VPC itself with the CIDR block, and there's a reference here which references VPC CIDR, which is specified back up here. We can see the key is name, the reference here is environment name, which we have specified elsewhere. We've then got an internet gateway being created, an internet gateway attachment. As you can see, the internet gateway attachment then has two properties. One is the internet gateway ID, and that references internet gateway, which is this element here. And then it also references the VPC ID. So it needs the VPC ID to know how to attach this internet gateway, which VPC to actually attach it to. We then have the configuration for each of our subnets. So this is public subnet 1. The type is AWS EC2 subnet. The VPC ID is then referenced. We have the CIDR block being referenced as well. And that links back to where we specified the CIDR block for the public subnet 1 at the top of the actual document. And then map public IP on launch is true. So this will be a public subnet and the instances will get public IP addresses. So then we have public subnet 2, private subnet 1, private subnet 2. And then we have our route tables. We have our default public route to the internet gateway being specified here. We have route table associations. And then we move into the private route tables. At the bottom, you've got all the outputs. So lots of information will be present in the output that can then be used externally or in another AWS stack. So that's a quick overview of the template file. And now we can go to CloudFormation and create our stack. Back in CloudFormation, let's create stack with new resources. I'm going to choose to upload a template file. And I'm going to choose my create VPC with CloudFormation template file. Choose next. Now here you give it a stack name, and then you can give it an environment name as well. We then have the opportunity to change the VPC CIDR block and the actual CIDRs that are added to each of the subnets. So if this does overlap with an existing VPC, you might need to do that. If you do, just make sure that you put in a VPC CIDR and then also update the subnets to make sure they're within that CIDR block. I'm going to click on next. I'm going to allow the stack to create using my own user credentials. I'm not going to use a role. I do want to roll back all stack resources if there's a failure. And then I'm just going to click on next, accept all of the defaults for the advanced options, and then click on create stack. And that's in progress. So the create is complete now. And by scrolling down, we can see all of the various activities that took place in the event log here. If I also go over to outputs, we can now see the outputs. So we've got the security group ID for our no ingress security group. And we can see the subnet IDs and also the VPC ID as well. So let's go into the VPC management console, choose VPCs, and we can see the VPC that we just created, and that's the CF test VPC. If I go to subnets, they've also got labels so that we can easily identify that they are part of that VPC. We can see the various subnets here. Under route tables, we should also have some route tables. And within those, we should have routes. For example, this one being the public route table has got a local route, but also a route to the internet gateway that was created as part of the stack creation. If we go to internet gateways, we can see the internet gateway that was created. And also, if we go down to security groups, we should see the no ingress SG. That was the group that was created. and it doesn't have any inbound rules, but it does have an allow rule for outbound. So that's really it. So as you can see, it's very powerful. We've just very easily created a VPC configuration just by deploying a simple template. So once you know the settings that you want to apply, if you want to do them over and over again in different regions, it becomes very easy to do. Now I've finished with my stack, so I'm going to click on delete, and it's going to delete the stack, and it should remove all of the resources automatically for you.